Every one of us in the Labor family is brokenhearted by the death of our beloved Peta Murphy.
Family and friends, politicians and campaigners all in mourning tonight after the death of a courageous Victorian MP. Peta Murphy, the member for Dunkley in the Mornington Peninsula, losing her long fight with cancer at the age of just 50. The Labor politician was a fierce advocate fighting for a national registry for patients whose cancer has metastasised. Joining me from Melbourne is the CEO of the Breast Cancer Network, Kirsten Pilatti. Kirsten, firstly, our condolences to you and your team. I know it's a difficult day for you. We thank you for joining us. Tell us, what legacy does Peta leave behind?
She leaves an incredible legacy, and it's very hard to believe that just on Wednesday we were there delivering a roadmap to the Australian government that Peta helped us to really deliver to them in a practical way. And yet here we are today sitting in the grief, and to all of those who are living with metastatic breast cancer, we send you our love today because we know it's hard.
It really says something about her character, doesn't it? That Peta appeared at Parliament last week, obviously wouldn't have been feeling the best because she wanted to launch the Breast Cancer Network's national report. What did that mean to you and your team?
It means the world to have someone like Peta, who shone a very bright light into a dark place that many people are often too afraid to talk about, and that is to talk about those people living with treatable but sadly incurable breast cancer, and in fact all cancers. And so today is a day for us to pay homage to the fact that she was willing to be and use her platform in a very powerful way. Mm.
The Prime Minister spoke about Peta's remarkable first speech to Parliament in 2019. I'd like to play some of that now. Have a listen.
Let's be frank. Cancer sucks. I am neither unique nor alone. Ladies, check your breasts. Men, stop ignoring what your body's telling you.
Both sides of politics had such respect for Peta. It was really her honesty that helped spread the message, wasn't it?
She keeps it very real, and, you know, I loved that in her maiden speech when she said, I am not unique nor alone, and she took that very seriously. And to see her connect with our network, with those people living with metastatic disease, to give them a voice and to give them a platform is something that we are very grateful for, but is something that will be a legacy that we promise we will continue to live on in her name.
So Peta advocated for a national registry for patients whose cancer has spread to different parts of their body. Why is that so important?
Well, it's unbelievable that in this day and age we still do not know how many people are living with metastatic breast cancer or, in fact, any cancers. How on earth do we deliver good treatment? How do we know if treatment is working if we cannot know the numbers of people that we are there to support with? And Peta got that. She got that her number was not being counted as she was living with metastatic disease. And so she really wanted to find a way forward. And BCNA has provided the government with a solution and a pathway forward. So we are really looking forward to leveraging the infrastructure that already exists, linking in with the Australian Cancer Plan to actually bring to life what Peta's wish was and what our wish is for, and that is that every Australian living with metastatic disease are counted in this country.
And do you think that that could help with outcomes and treatments?
I mean, we don't even know. We invest so heavily in a lot of new drugs and treatments, but if we don't know how many people are living with the disease, how do we know whether metastatic breast cancer is increasing or, in fact, decreasing around the country? How do we know how to provide the supportive care, the palliative care, all of those for the, all of those really important services for people if we do not have a baseline of how many people we know are living with this disease across the country?
Well, what a legacy she has. Thank you so much for coming on and talking to us about Peta and what she's done. Kirsten Pilatti.